So we have this machine, we have putty connected. So we just need to do all this. Select all of them. It says HTTPD, no such service or directory. So HTTPD currently not installed, so no issues. We don't require even in our case. Then we need to start HTTPD, just copy and paste them. So HTTP is not recognized because it is not installed, rest everything is okay. We already have done it in our HTTP thing, right? So in CentOS 7 basically these are the things, but we are not using CentOS 7. For CentOS 6 these are required. Then we need to fix Selinux, so we need to make it disabled. Okay, so I will say vi /etc/config, make it disabled. So copy this and do enter. So it says it's read only, so basically whatever you do, you need to put sudo in front of it. Why? Because Mimang10 is a sudoer user, okay? Because we are not using root user. So root, if you use root user, nobody will ask you what you are doing. But when you use some different user, it will check whether it is having proper authority to change, to do the changes in the file or not, right? So basically we are a sudo, this user is a sudoer user, but then it requires sudo command in order to do any changes. So I will come here now, this Selinux from enforcing to disable. Save it. That is done. Now we require some changes in our basics, this files, system control file, in order to, we already have gone through the swappiness. Okay, swappiness is just the process of offloading your RAM data into hard disk once it reaches to certain percentage of amount of RAM, right? So by default it would be 40%, now we need to set it to 90%. So we need to go to this particular file and go to bottom. Paste these two lines. Then we need to do the transparent huge pages. Copy these two lines. Save it. Then we need to change the etc host file. And one entry got added by Google itself, so we just need to delete it. That is this entry. Okay, I'm going to put it on my own. And this is the IP address that we are going to use for our machine. So this is the IP address. The name of that machine would be cdhm2.cluster.com. Then we have 3 for cdhs1.cluster.com. And if you see, this is the cdhs1. Then we do have 4, so 2, 3 and 4 is the internal IP address of this machine, cdhs2.cluster.com. So this is called FQDN and this is called SQDN. fully qualified domain name and simple domain name, whatever. Okay, so we have set it up our etc host file, and that we need to have this etc host file to be identical on all the machines. Which all the machine? CDHM2, CDHS1 and CDHS2. Okay, save it. Passwordless SSH we already need. Now we need to do that thing. So basically what we need to do is, currently we need to try to ping to CDHS1. So currently it is pinging. Why? Because it is in the same network. CDHS2 is also getting pinged. Okay, now in order to make the passwordless SSH for Mimand 10, what we do is we need to go to cd.ssh, pick the, so there is authorized keys. Okay, so so we can create copy the public key of master. Let me try to do SSH on CDHS1. Okay, so what I will do is I will create a password, SSH keygen. Okay, so that is already available. So I am saying SSH keygen and enter. If you do go cd.ssh, so here there is idrsa and idrsapub, right? So this idrsa.pub, that is the public key, we need to copy it into the authorized keys of rest of the machine so that we can have the passwordless SSH to be set up for Mimand 10 user from CDHM2 machine to CDHS1 and S2 that we already had seen, right? So these are my public and private key of my CDHM2 machine, out of which this dot pub is the public part. So I will get it, I will copy this, paste it somewhere, and now we'll log into the rest of the machines, the machine IP address, public IP address. I will pick them one by one. So this is CDHS1, I will pick them, open putty, copy IP address, give the authorized to be Google Cloud private key, and this is CDHS1. Now what I will do is, there should be some authorized keys folder already have been created, because while the creation of this machine, we already have given one public key to be copied, right? So this is CDHS1. Okay, so just be very careful. I am going into its SSH directory, and if I do ll, I will find one authorized keys. Okay, so I will do sudo vi authorized keys. Okay, and at the bottom I will copy this public key of my master 2. Okay, save it. Once saved, we should be okay connecting from CDHM2 to CDHS1 using passwordless SSH. Okay, so let me try that. I will do now SSH to slave 1. Sorry, CDH1. S1. Okay, what I will do is, I will just change the SQDN for this, actually 1 ETC hosts. So instead of CDHM1, okay, that would be okay, not a problem. So I will say SSH CDHS1, this is my first machine. I will say yes and now it says permuted it. Now let me exit out of it because I am now on S1. Let me again do the same thing. It should not ask any password for my month 10. And yes, we are good. Okay, so it did not ask and it directly logged into CDHS1 without any password. So we had set up the passwordless SSH for my month 10 user like that. So let me exit out of it and let me do the same thing for CDHS2. So I will copy this. Now here where some manual effort required, once this is set up, Ansible will take care of rest of the things. Because for Ansible to work, we should have passwordless SSH setup for the super user. So now this is CDHS2. So same thing we need to perform over here. Go to CDHSSH ULL and then do sudo vi authorized. Go to the end of it. Do be in insert mode and copy the public key of master 2 into it. Control C V. Save. Now passwordless SSH should work for here also. SSH CDHS2. Do exit. Do it again. And yes, we are good. Now we also need to set up the passwordless SSH from CDHM2 to CDHM2 itself, right? Because we have seen that even you install a sudo node cluster, you require a passwordless SSH to be set up for the, you know, super user. The same thing we will do. We need to copy the public key into the authorized keys of CDHM2 as well. So go to CDHSSS1 ULL. So we do need to copy the public key into authorized keys over here. Okay. So do sudo vi authorized keys. Okay, come down and do the same thing over here as well. Save. Now do SSH on CDHM2 from same machine to same machine. It will ask yes. Do exit. Do again. So see, it is not asking the password anymore. So for all the three machines, CDHM2, CDHS1 and CDHS2, we have set up the passwordless login for demand 10 user, okay, from CDHM2. We are good. Okay, once we do that, we need to install sudo yum install ansible So it will automatically bring the latest Ansible version available on the repository. It's getting downloaded now, getting installed. Okay, so Ansible is available now. You can just write Ansible and you will find lot of options to run it. Okay, so we will now use Ansible. So Ansible is having certain configuration files somewhere, right? So I need to go to /etc/ ansible there should be hosts file, roles file, and ansible.cfg. So ansible.cfg is the file in which you can just know if you can just get it. There are a lot of things you can, you know, so there are some defaults. We are going with defaults only, but then when you, you know, go one more step up in order to make it more, you can say optimized in terms of whatever you're doing, you may need to come here and do some changes over here, right? So if you see most of the lines, they are all commented. They're commented means whatever the properties it is they are holding, basically, they're all using default one, right? So what we do here is there is a host file of Ansible in /etc/ansible/host. So we need to create two entries over here. So I will say sudo vi hosts, go to bottom and create entries like this. Okay, so I will say master . So I will create an entry for master and I will register this machine in under the master. You can say master would be a kind of group, and in that group we are registering this machine called cdhm2.cluster.com. Okay, so you can create multiple such groups, and then so I will say slave, slave. And in that slave group, I'm going to create I'm going to register cdhs1.cluster.com, cdhs2.cluster.com. Okay. So when I want to do with something with this machine, I can just select the group master, and inside this master group, whatever number of machines those are registered under this basically will be automatically taken care by Ansible. Similarly, this slave is one more group under which these two machines are coming. So if you do something with slave group, all these machines will be affected. Okay, so if you want to do some kind of installation on slave, that component will be installed on all these machines. If you want to do some kind of configuration changes on slave, all these S1 and S2 machine will be changed. Okay, now one machine can be the part of multiple groups. Okay, it depends. I mean, it depends completely on you. Okay. So I will say one master group and then another one is a slave group. Okay, so this is actually the hosts of Ansible. I mean, Ansible will treat them in their host file to be the independent machines. So cdhs1, cdhs2, cluster.plus. Here the name spelling is a mistake. Cluster.com. Okay. Let me save it. Now if that is the case, let me first try to ping. So I will say ansible. This is how you will run ad hoc commands. So I will say ansible minus m is the module. Module name would be ping. And then let me just check it how I can run the ad hoc command. Okay, so ansible ping, and let me just, sorry, not master 2. Okay, so Ansible, then you say hyphen m. So hyphen m, then you need to provide the name of the module. So Ansible supports around 400 modules. So the list of the modules are quite large. And each module is doing one kind of activity. Okay, so ping is one of the kind of activity. Now, if I want to do the same thing with slave machine, I will say Ansible hyphen m. Will take some time, so let me again do it. Okay, so Ansible is now successfully executed the ping module on the slave. It means that now Ansible is able to see both all the machines, right? So if you want to do test the ping module on all, in all the machines, so you need not to provide only master or slave, just provide all. So all will, it means that it will consider all the groups in your Ansible host, right? So we have created one master group and one create, and we have created one slave group. So when we say all, it will hit all the module, all the groups, okay? And if you see, when I say Ansible hyphen ping, Ansible hyphen module, and then the module name is ping and all, it has pinged all the machines. So it says ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, okay? So this is successful, it says success, CDHS1 is success, and S2 is also success, okay? So our Ansible is set up and we can now use it to flow our configuration files from one machine to other machine. So let me clear it. Now we will create a playbook. Okay, the name of the playbook could be anything you want to play. So I will create a playbook called VI setup dot YAML. So, and then, sorry, let me put sudo in front of it. I will copy this. So what it will do is, when you write YAML, the syntax needs to be followed exactly. You cannot, there are three dashes, then you need to follow one space, then dash space, and then host name, slave. So this should be exactly matched, okay? You cannot displace any of this character from left to right or right to left, okay? That is very, YAML is very strict in that, okay? So you need to follow this syntax properly. Otherwise, you know, your Ansible keeps giving you some syntax error, okay? Though the language is quite simple, but then it requires you to be very structured. Now what we are doing is, so in this playbook basically, we are copying the etc host file, okay, from the source to destination. And source would be what? Source would be our current machine. So our current machine, because we have installed our Ansible on CDHM2, that would be our current machine. From that particular machine, the etc hosts file will be copied to the destination. What is our destination? CDHS1 and S2. Okay, because our destination is host slave. So we are actually running from our master machine to the slave machine. So everything will be copied. So etc host will be copied from master machine to both the slave machine. Similarly, say Linux also will be copied. This will be also copied. This will be also copied. Then we need to make disable of IP tables, right? So currently it is disabled on master. We already have manually disabled it, but then we need to disable it like this on our slave machines. Okay. And NTPD needs to be started. We already have started it on our NTPD is network time protocol. So let me save it. And we now need to run this by saying Ansible playbook. And provide the name of the playbook, that's it. Run it. So it will tell you that there are eight okay, six changes have been done. Okay, it means that if you go to etc host file on CDHS1, right, you will find that it got changed automatically. Okay, you did not change it, Ansible has changed it. And you see this, all the entries have automatically come. Even if you go on CDHS2 and get on /etc/hosts, you will see that all things have come up over here, right? Now you even don't need to keep the windows for this CDHS1 and S2 open, right? So you just easily close them. They are running, but then we don't want to access them directly now, because we need to do everything through Ansible, and we also have the passwordless SSH set up from CDHM2 to CDHS1 and S2. So